June is one of the most important months for gaming and one of the most exciting. It's like a holiday for gamers and even Christmas, if you will, where gamers get excited to see what brand new games are announced for their favorite consoles. And Nintendo is no exception. Nintendo normally has a giant presentation at E3 showcasing what's coming out to the console either this year or the next, and it's always an exciting time to prepare and predict what they're going to announce. Unfortunately, 2020's E3 presentations have been canceled. E3 has been canceled altogether because of the virus that has been spreading across the nation, and unfortunately, it looks like there will be no type of presentations like we normally get, and this is kind of heart-wrenching. This is something that most gamers have been looking forward to for a long time, and for Nintendo to say they needed it big time. Nintendo has really been mostly silent since last year's E3, and since then we really haven't gotten any big brand new Nintendo game reveals, and it's been pretty much quiet for a whole 365 days from the company. So obviously this E3 was kind of big and everybody was riding on it, but of course, since the world is going into chaos right now, that was not possible. Well, before we get started discussing what Nintendo is going to do this year and for June, please feel free to subscribe if you guys are new and like the video if you enjoyed it. It really goes a long way. And also feel free to join the official Nintendo Land Discord where you too can chat with everybody in the chat and get your name appearing at the beginning of my videos. So other companies have been making plans and scheduling ways to get this information out to their fans since the cancellation of E3, such as the Summer Game Fest, which is a way that runs all the way throughout summer for companies to get their game information out to their fans, because that is still important. There's still no way you should stay silent about what you have coming out and still be able to get your fans excited and give them something to look forward to during the dark times, and that's what companies are doing. Literally every company, except of course Nintendo. Nintendo did not sign up to join the Summer Game Fest and has made no announcements for when they would reveal any information regarding anything from the company, which is kind of bizarre, even for Nintendo. What makes matters even worse is we're getting rumors giving us negative information this time instead of positive vibes, which is the first, and they're telling us that Nintendo doesn't have a direct plan anytime soon, not even one for June, or even later than that. And it's kind of weird. Like I said, I've never really been in a time where Nintendo just has been completely silent all the way through the year. I mean, it's so weird. And with no E3, no directs coming, how in the world are they going to get information out? Well, they've been showing us that they've been doing some couple different ways, but is that necessarily the best way to approach fans with new information? Well, let's talk about it. Nintendo has seemed to push away directs or presentations of any sort and replace for game drops. They simply just look like they're dropping games on Twitter or YouTube at the moment, which is good and bad. It's good to hurry up and get games out and see, oh, this is coming out in just a couple of months. This is a nice surprise, but I think it's a nice surprise simply due to the fact that anything will be a nice surprise right now from Nintendo, because it's been, like I said, almost over a year without any big information revealed. So anything would be surprising to wake up to, but at the same time, is this the best way? There's just something to be said about watching and making prediction videos with people and seeing if our predictions come true, making bingo boards and just seeing all the possibilities that Nintendo could do. We would say some crazy things like maybe there's going to be a brand new F-Zero for once, or Mother 3 is going to come, and it's just like it would never happen, but it was so exciting to prepare for and get excited for. Like, yes, there's a direct coming this Thursday, let's prepare, you know, and we don't really have that anymore. It's more like let's wake up and cross our fingers and see if something was dropped on Twitter, and it's a completely different feel. And that right there is why E3 was so important, why June is so important. It's smack dab in the middle of the summer, and it's normally around the time where we not only get little games and big games towards the end of the year, but giant titles coming out in the future, such as the next couple of years. Take Breath of the Wild 2, for instance. That was announced last year at E3, and we still have no clue when it's coming, because it was such a big reveal title. Yes, I know I wish we could actually have a confirmed release date if they're showing us a trailer of the game, but it was just exciting to see that. Metroid Prime 4 getting announced, and it was just, yes, they had to go back in development, but it's still so exciting to hear that that game was coming, and it gave people information to talk about. It gave people, a reason to go online and make discussions and videos on YouTube about theories of the game, and it was just an exciting time. You know, you could feel Nintendo in the air, and right now, you don't. You really don't at all. In fact, you see a lot of Sony information coming out as they're having many presentations coming up. You have Microsoft having monthly presentations, and it just feels like it's their time to shine, and Nintendo's just sitting in the background, in the corner, sadly, with Paper Mario, the only thing they announced. I love Paper Mario to death, and I can't wait, but they need more than that. well, let's stop and take a break and look at exactly what we have coming right now and kind of count our blessings, if we will, about what we have instead of looking about what we don't have. We have Pokemon DLC coming. We have two packs and they just revealed more information about them. And one of them is coming very soon here in June, which is exciting. And then Paper Mario in July, which is still keeping a roll. You know, at least we have June and July covered with some pretty big information games coming, since Paper Mario is in July. It's a brand new, finally a big brand new first party Nintendo game. But then what's coming afterwards and what's coming in the future for 2020? Well, obviously we're still focused on June and announcements from Nintendo. So what else could Nintendo announce here in June? Well, there's still potential for more announcements, okay? We could still wake up the next morning and find out Nintendo announced a brand new 3D Mario collection. And why do I say 3D Mario collection? Well, there's tons and tons of high quality rumors and leaks showing us that Nintendo has a lot of plans still for 2020, and they just still have not yet revealed them. And that's what's still exciting. Still. Something else that I think a lot of people are also forgetting about this month is we could probably potentially get the next DLC fighter for Smash Ultimate, which is somebody from ARMS. Could be pretty exciting. So we could definitely get a presentation from Sakurai himself, as he might just record himself in his own studio playing, which is very possible. But on his past videos, it seems like he's always had a crowd in the background. You could hear them laughing, or I don't know if that was edited in. I don't know. But it seemed like people were there with him, so I'm not sure if Sakurai could go this. He could definitely do it by himself. After all, he is playing with both characters with two controllers, so he can definitely do it by himself. But Sakurai might just put up an overview trailer of just showcasing what he can do. That's what we used to have for characters, and I wish that they kind of went back to that. It was a lot of fun to give creators more time to mess around with the character and showcase them. Instead of Sakurai going on for 40 minutes about the character, he could just show off a quick trailer like we used to, such as Cloud and Bayonetta, and be like, okay, this character's pretty cool, I can't wait to get my hands on them. And it makes it more exciting to jump into the game and play around with the character and find some new things that you didn't see in the trailer. And maybe they can go that route, just drop a trailer earlier in the morning and sometime in the week and say, hey, this character is out now, Springman's out now, or these ARM characters are out now. And that would be very exciting. But remember, this is supposed to come out in the summer, and Sakurai has been giving updates all year talking about how well production is going, and it's a lot easier to develop a character over a game. And he's having a pretty good time developing this character. So maybe this character is further along than we think, and we could be getting something with this character very soon here, either June and July, and maybe just an announcement here in June for the character to reveal in July. So keep your eye out for this character. I think it's going to be very exciting, and it could be very soon. But going back to those rumors about all the games coming soon, there are a lot of them, and lots of them are remakes. And even a credible source, Emily Rogers, has stated that yes, this year is going to be a great year for remakes and remasters. And yes, I think it is, because we still have rumors and leaks of a whole bunch of games coming, such as 3D Mario Remasters, Pikmin 3, Mario 3D World Remaster, and much, much more. There's still Metroid Prime Trilogy, a 2D Metroid possibly coming, and it just keeps on piling up with the rumors. But these were all kind of announced like a couple of weeks ago to come very soon. I know as soon as Paper Mario dropped, lots of people were saying, okay, next is Pikmin 3 and the Mario 3D remasters. They're coming very soon, as like super soon as that day, which was like 2 weeks ago. And we still have heard nothing. So I don't know how credible the rest of these are. Hopefully they are very credible. Paper Mario came true. That was a heavily rumored and leaked game from the beginning of this year, and it finally came into fruition. So we could still be getting those 3D Mario remasters, which to me at least is a pretty big deal and just as big as a brand new 3D Mario game in and of itself. So there's still games that could be coming, and lots of these, since they're remakes and remasters, could just be dropped on Twitter or their YouTube page early one morning. So what is the month of June for Nintendo? Well, clearly they're probably not going to have a presentation, as something should have been announced already. A Direct still could happen, but rumors are suggesting otherwise. So right now it looks like for June and for the rest of the summer, we could just be getting game trailers dropped on their channel. But we've only gotten Paper Mario so far, and I think lots of us expected more the following weeks, and we haven't gotten anything else yet. This week, I still don't know if I would expect anything. There's a lot of stuff going around the world, and they may have pushed stuff back. Also, considering the fact that Pokemon got revealed this week, and they normally only focus with one thing a week, I doubt anything else will come this week, but be prepared. I would look at Thursday mornings as well. It seems to be the trend for a lot of the times they start revealing information, whether it's directs or just gameplay drops. But I leave it to you guys. What do you think Nintendo does for June and for the rest of the year, and even this summer? Do they go back to presentations and directs, or are they going to continue to put out trailers? And which one do you prefer? Do you miss the directs where you got excited and ready for presentations and game reveals, or do you like to just wake up one morning and be surprised? Let me know in the comments down below, and like I said before, please like the video if you enjoyed, it really helps me out a lot, and subscribe if you guys are new to stay up to date on all things Nintendo. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya guys.